Hey crafters, it's Monica with Scrapping for My Boys. I finally finished the mini album for my swap with Monique over at Butterbeescraps. This has been months and months in the making. I am finally done. I'm shooting this video December 30th. I finished it 2 days ago on the 28th, or was it the 27th? Whatever. Anyways, well, I'm finally done, so I'm here to share it with you. Okay. So, and don't mind the camera angles. I'm trying something a little different, and we'll see how this goes. I pre-shot this video earlier, and it took 41 minutes, so I'm re-recording. So, hopefully, second time's a charm. Alrighty, so here is the mini. The mini measures 8x8, the chipboard at least. The inside, I believe, is 7.5x7.5. I use the Laura Dennison Stacked Deck binding. Let's see, I use paper bags for this album. Instead of the standard paper bag layout, what I did is, if you're familiar with Kathy Order Paper Phenomenon, her Ultimate Paper Bag album, I took her bag assembly, just basically the way she folds it down to make it wider. That's the method that I chose, and I just cut off the edge strip to go ahead and be able to bind it with the stack the deck binding. So, okay, let's go ahead and get this started. And here what we have is, I used the paper collection that I use is the Paper Studio, which I got at Hobby Lobby, and it is called, let me grab the paper stack. It is called Poetic. It's called Poetic Postage, and it's 8.5x11 paper stack. Okay, so here what we have is, we have a whole bunch of I Am Roses and Wild Orchid Crafts flowers. Majority of them are are Wild Orchid Crafts. I will point out which ones are I Am Roses. The leaves are all I Am Roses. Those are for sure. Okay, so let's go ahead and get started real quick. I'm going to try to speed through this because this is a really long, it's a lot of stuff, and the first time I recorded it, it came out to 41 minutes, so I completely have to cut that down. So here we have a large, this was a cream gardenia from Wild Orchid Crafts. I colored it with my Distress Inks, and I did a two-tone. Here on the outside you have aged mahogany, and on the inside I used walnut stain. And I'll just go ahead and mention all of the colors that I used. All of the reds that you'll see will be aged mahogany. All these dark, deep gold, which doesn't really look gold on camera, are the Lindy's Magical Micas and the Bayou Boogie Gold. I also sprayed pretty much all of the flowers with the Lindy Starburst in Glories of the Seas Gold to give it the gold shimmer. And let's see, what else did I color? That's about it. Those are the three colors that I use throughout the entire album from all the flowers, so I won't mention which colors I use since they'll all be really obvious. So this is a 1.25-inch wild rose. Here we have a 1-inch crystal bauble. The black bling flourishes here are from Recollections. Both the front and back, the corners have the Tim Holtz metal corners, and I use the ones in the antique gold. Right here we have, let's move this to the side, light turned all yellow. I need to get an out light, that's what I need. Here is a metal embellishment that I received from Mo. Then over here, in this corner, and also what I'll do is I'll also add still shots of everything at the end of the video, that way you guys can see it closely, because I know the lighting's really bad. Okay, so in this corner we have a 1.75-inch trellis rose. Here we have a little carnation. These are two little hip rosebuds. We have a 1-inch jet black open rose. We have a large wild rosebud. We have a 1.5-inch wild rose here. The stem here with the two little buds are the white stem gypsophilia. The small gardenia is actually the two-tone brown from I Am Roses. Here you have the, I believe these are the large white rose leaves from I Am Roses, which I colored in the Glories of the Seas Gold. Then you have some green ones that are tucked in back here. Right underneath you have two little pieces of the black Wild Orchid Crafts Sky Pure Lace, which is really hard to see here on camera, but when you look at it in person, then you'll also be able to see it in the pictures. Another thing that is added on the covers is the metal flower embellishments from Monique Crafts. I basically cut it in half, and I tucked half of it here, and the other half you see is tucked right back there. I used two different papers to do the covers of the mini album. And what I did to cover up basically the joining crease of the papers, I used a Cheerylynn Designs border die. This is the border Carnivale, and you'll see it several times throughout the album. So here is the paper that is on the front and back, the front and back cover. This is it's a damask, and it's also got like postcards on it. It's really, really pretty. Then on the spine, which you see the spine is huge. The spine is just a little over 5 1/4 inches wide. It's huge. So this one is a script paper. So what I did was I have some black We Are Memory Keepers extra wide eyelets. I punched the holes on both the top and bottom. I strung a black chain and I crisscrossed it. And then I added a Tim Holtz swivel clasp. And I hung two little charms off of it. Let's see, you have this metallic key I got from my friend Shelly Ann. The camera, I'm not sure if it came from Shelly or if it came from Mo. Those are the only two people that have actually given me charms. So I'm not exactly sure who the camera came from. And here I got a big old crystal bauble right there. And we have the Tim Holtz ornate plate, and I put her name in the middle. So here's the back, same thing, really simple. Kept it nice and flat. You have the Tim Holtz corners. You have that border, the border die strip. Here is just, I used the Spellbinders Labels 9, which is, you're going to see throughout the album as well. It just says limited edition by Monica Rocha, and it says December of 2012. So the closure, I'm not happy with. I couldn't decide what I wanted to do. So you have the black extra wide eyelets on both sides. You have the start here with a swivel clasp. Then we have a little heart charm. Alrighty, I'm back. I was in the middle of talking about the closure and the camera died, so I had to go ahead and plug the camera in so I can keep going. So like where I left off, these two charms are from my friend Shelly Ann. And here is a little jewelry necklace hook for the closure. I didn't have any gold, like the antique gold chain, so the closest thing that I had was the Tim Holtz ball chain, which I really don't like the way it looks, but I didn't like the way ribbon looked either. So Mo, if you want to change this back part, you can you can do whatever you want. And I also left it a little long, that's why it's dangling, because I didn't know how chunky-er it was going to get once she added all of her stuff. So once she adds her pictures and everything she wants to it, she can go ahead and cut off the extra ball chain to keep it tighter if she wants the closure to be further up. So let's go ahead and open this up. And this is going to be some weird angles. Because when I shot the other video, I had a lot of problems with holding it up. Alrighty, so the inside is just plain. I have a little clip here because I actually have some journaling spots that I'm adding here. So here, it's stuck over here. So here on the spine, you see that border die cut it as well again. Here's the first page. Throughout the album, on the corner of all the pages, I use the Martha Stewart DecoFan border punch. And you see the corners, and then you'll see a few areas that I actually use the around the page punch. So here we have a Cheerylynn die. This is the Sophia's heart. Which I love. That's the die cut in black. This top doily is a Spellbinders, and I believe it's called the Picket Edges. Here we have the Tim Holtz flourishes. This is a smaller flourish of the two, and this one is cut out of chipboard, and I embossed it with Lindy Stamp Gang in the midnight gold. Here we have large maple leaves from I Am Roses, and they're green already, but I wanted to darken them up, so I used the Cathedral Pines Green Lindy Starburst. We have two cherry blossoms here. Then here is another wild rose. Here's another black 1-inch open rose. And here's just a metal piece that I got from my friend Shelly Ann. So the first tag, let me go ahead and set this down. all the tags in the album are pretty much the same layout. I'm not a tag maker, so I had a lot of trouble coming up with this, but I came up with the prototype and I ended up sticking to it. And when I was working on them, I didn't realize how long they were actually taking me to do. And I ended up changing my mind and regretting it as I was going through it. But once you get started, you can't really go back and change your mind, because I was already delayed, so I wanted to hurry up and get it finished. So what I did is I have a corner die. This is a Marianne's Creatable die. And all of the Cheerylynn dies that I have, the Marianne Creatables, and I believe I also use Memory Box dies in this album, I got off... hi, baby. Hold on. My little one's here. Go play with your brother, baby. Go play. I got from Darlene over at Dutch Paper Crafts. Over, she has a blog store, and she always gives really good deals. She sells them a little lower than the MSRP from where you get at the stores. So, okay, continuing on. So I cut the corners out on both sides. The tag from the black part of the cardstock is 7x7. So I cut it out, I dry embossed it, and then I went over it with my Perfect Medium pen, and I went over it in Perfect Gold, Perfect Pearls. All of the brown tags have the Perfect Gold. The black tags all have the Perfect Bronze. So the tags are identical on the front and back, same exact layout as you have here. So here you have Blaine, the flowers. Here is the Labels 9. Labels 9 Spellbinders. This stamp is a Hero Arts stamp. It is the quotes background. Here we have a Memento swirly circle paperclip. And it's not attached, so she can go ahead and take it off. So the back looks exactly the same. The only thing that differs between the tags is the paper that I use with the layout. The photo mats that I set up for all of the tags are various sizes, so I'm not really going to go into measuring them because it's just going to make the video extra long. That was the problem that I had when I first shot the video. So let's tuck this back in. The back page, let's go ahead and lift this up, is this one here. And this was the first page that I actually started decorating. And I have the flap here and it doesn't have a closure. I could not find my magnetic snaps to save my life. So I went ahead and I moved forward because I got all pissed off. And now I regret it because it just keeps flapping open. And I just don't want to go back and add it. So here's a photo mat, which opens up. We have another photo mat on the inside. Here we have, I think this is a standard size tags. What I went ahead and did is I distressed it with aged mahogany. And then I went over the edges with walnut stain for the darker look. This stamp here is a Tim Holtz stamp from the, that is a Nature's Garden stamp, from the Nature's Garden set. And I stamped it on both sides, and I embossed it with the Midnight Gold Lindy Stamping Embossing Powder. Here we have the Mini Fanciful Flourish. We have some Walter Cross Flat Blooms. The center here is part of a rhinestone flower trim that I have, and I just used it for the center of that flower. Here is another wild rose. This is a 1.5 inch. Another flat bloom. And here is another piece of that gold embellishment that you saw on the cover underneath the large gardenia. I cut it in half and put it on either side of the large wild rose. So for the next page, we have this little flappy thing. Ugh, let me hold this. Ah, I know what I'll do. Let me clip this. See if it stays. No, it doesn't stay. Never mind. Okay. It's a little flap. We have two large metal corners from Waldricker Crafts that I alcohol inked in black. We have a black chain that I hung on the other on either side of these little gold little itty bitty butterflies. They were charms, and I just cut off the little charm hooky thingy. Here is a cherry blossom. This charm I got from Shelley. You got some Kaiser Craft flatback pearls here. Here are some more flat blooms with that rhinestone flower center. Here is a metal flower from Waldricker Crafts. I'll go ahead and bring it up closely so you can see it. Then you have the two I Am Roses leaves. Two small, I believe those are half-inch black roses, which I got from Mo. You've got the white Drosophila stem flowers there, and you have two hip rosebuds here. Hold on a second. Eddie, I'm recording a video, so please go out in the living room. And I'm not opening up any more toys, so go, please. No, please stop talking. Go. No, you will not. Okay, I'm back again. Had to stop the video because the little one decides to start getting a little smart mouth, so I had to go put him in check. Keeps trying to open more Christmas toys, which is driving me crazy. Alrighty, so I already went over all the flowers. This little clippy comes off, and it opens up for photo mats, journaling spots, whatever you want to use it for, Mo. It's all up to you. And the last thing that I did, these two butterflies here, I glossy accented them. So if you can see that there. Here is the next tag. And this was the first tag. Let me lay the album down. This is my prototype. This is the first one that I came up with. And Jules loved this tag. So I ended up sticking with it. She just told me to go ahead and go with it. So if you can see, all of them are the same. This one actually doesn't have the background on it as the other one did. The other one had this in brown, and then it was lined with black cardstock. So here it is. So these... on these black ones here is where you see where I use the Perfect Bronze, Perfect Pearls. So there's the tag. There's the Spellbinders Labels 9. And all of this is inked with black soot. All right, so let's keep going. I'm already at like 15 minutes, so I need to move a little faster. Next page. These set of pages are probably my two favorites of the whole album. Here we have that same Anja corner here, and if you notice, the die itself is only meant to cut out the corners here. So what I had to do was I fussy cut the corners four times. I basically cut out the corners four times and then fussy cut them to go ahead and adhere down on the paper. And on these ones, I didn't use Perfect Pearls. I went and embossed them with the Lindy Stamping embossing pattern. Out, Eddie. So down here on this corner, we have these pearl sprays here, and I just looped it three times, and it is on another small I Am Roses two-tone brown gardenia. On this corner up here, you have the same gardenia. Then we have two cherry blossoms that were colored with the aged mahogany, and these two metal flourishes are from the Memento line that Michaels carries. You have another pearl little loopy here, and two of the smaller I Am Roses rose leaves. In the center here, you have the Cheerylynn Polynesian Oval Sails die. And if you notice, in the middle of each of the flowers here, I added a little small rhinestone, some little bling. I left the background open because I don't have the Oval Spellbinders die, and I asked Mo if she had it, and she does. So she'll just go ahead and cut out her picture and adhere it directly over here, and the photos can tuck in underneath. Moving to the next page. Moving to the next page here, there's two pockets. The tags are really, really simple. I use the Tim Holtz ornate plate on the edge die. The stamp here is from an Inka Dinka Doo stamp set. It is called Your Neat Flourishes. And the front and back is exactly the same. So I'm not going to go ahead and flip it over. The top one here is pretty much the same on the back. This stamp set here, this flourish stamp set, is from a Close to My Heart acrylic stamp set, and it's the stamp set called Potential. So there's that, and it's embossed in black embossing powder, and both of the tags were sprayed with the Glories of the Seas gold. So for the bottom here, this little doily here is actually part of the Polynesian Sails die. It actually is part of the center of this one. So I went ahead and I cut it out, and I stamped it with a stamp that says, Live well, laugh often, love much. And that is from Stamp Set, if I can find it. That one is from, let's see, I believe it's a Paper Studio stamp set. I can't recall, and I don't know where it is. But I believe it's the Boho Blooms. That's what it is, the Boho Blooms stamp set by the Paper Studio. Here is the Memory Box die that I mentioned earlier. It is two dies. It is the Vivienne and the Darla butterfly die. So I adhered both of them together. I embossed the frame of the flower, I'm sorry, not the flower, the butterfly with the Lindy's Midnight Gold, and then I basically stickled all the little inner parts of it. I used the Black Diamond stickles, this one up here, I don't know the name of it, and I can't find the name on the little stickles bottle. And then the one here in the center, like the little, the ones that look like craft, it's like this iridescent type of, it's not a stickles, it's a sparkles. I believe it's also by Ranger. Okay, speeding along. So we have two cottage roses here. We have another 1.5-inch wild rose, some more I Am Roses, small rose leaves. We have some ball chains that I looped 3 times, and I actually glossy accented them down, that way they weren't moving around, otherwise they just keep falling down in between the flowers. On the bottom part here, go ahead and give you a little close-up right there, I made my own box pleated trim out of satin ribbon, black satin ribbon, and I got the tutorial off Leonie for My Passion for Paper. Here you have 2 rows of the black and silver mesh bling. And right up top we have, I believe it's called the Chinese rope trim, I'm not sure, it's a wild guess. It's in burgundy and it's about 1/4 inch wide, and I got this from Jules, the Paper Bag Lady 1. So the next tag is this one here. So if you notice, they all look the same, just the layout of where the flowers are and where the journaling spot is what's different about them. Okay, so next page. And these two are my least two favorite of all of them that I did. So here we have some more blooms. Here is another Cheerylynn butterfly that I cut out of gold foil paper, some more rose leaves. Here's a larger cutout of the Labels 9 Spellbinders. And this is a stamp that I got. It's on a wooden block. It's, I believe, from the $1.50 section at Michael's. This rectangle in the back is the Mediterranean lace rectangle frame die from Cheerylynn, and I have them on both sides. This flap opens to show, oops, it's held by a magnetic snap here. Ah, for photos, journaling, whatever she wants. Some more blooms right here, and here is some of the black Wilder Craft Sky Pure lace, and I don't believe they sell it anymore. I love that lace, and I can't find it anymore. I haven't seen it on the site in ages. So here is that Mediterranean lace frame here. You have that same Border Carnivale strip here on both sides. Some more blooms, and the mini fanciful flourish here in the gold. Maybe a little close-up. And that just basically mirror images the corner over here. Here's the tag for this pocket. Okay, let's see. Trying to get this back in the pocket. Next page. Here we have the Sophia's Heart Doily die again, and I didn't put anything over it so she can decide what size photo or whatever she wanted to put on there. Plus, I like the look of the die. Here's another 1.5-inch wild rose. We have 2 sweetheart blossoms, another 1-inch jet black rose. This here is the MFT medium leafy flourish die, and I cut that out of thin chipboard and embossed it in the Midnight Gold embossing powder from Lindy Stamping. We have 2 little charms here. It's a key and one's a cat, and I just went ahead and adhered it down right there. Here's some more of the box pleated trim that I made. There's a layer in black and then another layer of, it's kind of like, I guess, champagne color. And here is that flower trim that I was talking about earlier that I used as flower centers on a few of the first pages and the flowers in the front. This one I had originally set to make it as a waterfall, but I decided to leave out the pull tab thingy to go ahead and open it up by itself so you could just flip up through it. We got some Kaiser Craft flatback pearls in black here. This is the butterfly and moths stamp from Tim Holtz, and I actually borrowed this from my friend Paula. She's PA Muse here on YouTube, I believe. We went to a crop together, so I got to borrow that, and I embossed it with the Ranger's Gold Superfine Detail Embossing Powder. This fleur-de-lis stamp here is from that same Close to My Heart set that you saw the flourish on the bottom of the tag on the other page. Here's another one of those small doilies from that Polynesian sales doily die. And the inside, there's nothing special. It's just photo mats, journaling spots, whatever she wants to use these for. Here's the tag for this page. Okay, and we're getting close to the end here. So here we have another little page. Here on the back, these are the Fanciful Flourish. This is the next size up above the mini. All the other ones you see are the mini. This is the next size up in black, and then I basically cut two out, and then I cut them apart. So you have pieces here, and then you have pieces on this side here. Right here is some more of the box pleated trim that I made, and I just basically made it to be the base of my flower. I used three curly gardenia loose petals from my roses that I colored in the distress inks. I have an acrylic ribbon buckle and a flatback pearl in the center. And I left this open here so she can go ahead and put down whatever she wanted, whether tuck in some journaling spots, put a photo there, whatever she wanted. It's up to her. So this has a magnetic closure, and it go ahead and opens. I'm just going to go flip through them so you can see them. Alrighty, let's close that up. Then on this page, it is a pocket page. Here you have that same border Carnivale Cheerylynn strips, and I put it on both sides. This is box pleated trim. It's actually It's basically the double-ended one, so it pleats on both sides instead of just the bottom. And there's some more of that Chinese rope trim, and one strip of the black and silver mesh bling. This is another little metal embellishment that I got from Shelley, and it actually opens up so she can put a little picture or something in the center there. And I tried to adhere some metal to all the pages because Mo loves metal. And she's gotten me and Jules and everybody else loving metal, so I tried to incorporate it at least on one of the pages on each layout. Here are two tags that I created. I'm not too pleased with them, but it is what it is. They're not awful, but they're not great either. So here is that memory box die again, and here it is separated. You have the base, which is the Darla, and the top one is the Vivienne. Here's the Fanciful Flourish, the mini one. Some more blooms. This flourish up here on this corner and this one is from the Paper Studio stamp set, the Boho Blooms. This is the sentiment from, this is the quote, I should say, from the Nature's Discovery Tim Holtz stamp set. This one is also another Tim Holtz stamp. This is from the Floral Tattoo stamp set. There's the back. I colored the tags with aged mahogany, and then I sprayed the entire tag with the Glories of the Seas Gold. And excuse my kids in the background, they're being loud and obnoxious, and Dad isn't home to keep them in check while I record the video. And then you got some fibers, some random fibers that I had. And then it has a black We Are Memory Keepers extra wide eyelet. The other tag is this one. And this is just a simple one. It has that Dream Big stamp and then the Flourish corners there. I colored the tag in all three of the distress inks, aged mahogany, walnut stained, vintage photo, and sprayed it with the Glories of the Seas Gold, and inked the edges with black soot. There's the back. This is the back of the page, the pocket page. Here you have two more of those corners, the Anja corners. Tuck that in. And then the tag for this final page, she can actually put a vertical photo on here. And the journaling spot is not adhered down here on this part, so she can go ahead and tuck her photo behind it. Here's the back, and if you see, you see the bling. So the front and back are all identical on all of them. The only differences are the paper. So the last page is this one. We have that same Mediterranean lace Cheerylynn rectangle die. You have the Sophia's Heart doily die here. You have the Fanciful Flourish both here and here. You have some more of the Wild Orchid Cross blooms up in the corner. You have two sweetheart blossoms here. Another 1 1/4 inch wild rose. These are the puffy daisies from I Am Roses. I know Wild Orchid Cross carries them as well. This is another WOC bloom. And all the little rhinestone blings that you see throughout the album are all recollections. Here's some more of the guy pure lace. I just cut two pieces off and I put them here. The stick pin here was actually created by Lahuan. She's LK Juani here on YouTube. We did a cigar box swap over at Mass several months ago, and she gave me several stick pins, and I had yet to use them, so I figured I'd use one in the album. So here's the back. There's nothing on it. The paper is actually already embossed itself. I didn't glossy accent it on these. So here you go. Here is the completed mini album. As you can see, it is extremely fat. The gutter is half of an inch on each page. I wanted to leave plenty of room because I knew I wanted to do very dimensional flowers, and I just didn't know how many I was going to have. But all in all, it's okay. I love the album. I want to keep it. Mo, you're lucky that I love you. Otherwise, I'd be keeping this album. But I had a lot of fun creating this. I was really stressed out about it, creating something for Mo. But it all turned out well. I really, really hope you love this. I tried to keep you in mind when I did it, but you kept telling me that you wanted me to create it as if it was for me, my style. So I try to incorporate both. So hopefully you like it. And hopefully you get this soon so I can get this video up, because everybody is driving me crazy wanting to see the video, because this has been a long time coming. And if you can see, let me go ahead and move the camera. For those of you who don't know, who haven't seen, there is her mini that she sent me. I got it about 3.5 weeks ago, and it's been waiting, so I have it up there, and I stare at it all the time. Alrighty, everybody. I'm going to go ahead and add still shots at the end so you guys can get a better look at it, because I know the video and the lighting was pretty awful. So go ahead and leave me your comments. I'd love to hear feedback, since this is my first fully completed mini album. Actually, no, I lied, because I had that Disney mini album, which was crap, and then I had that chipboard album that I did earlier. Okay, this is my third, but this is the first one that I actually like, so go ahead and leave me your feedback. I greatly appreciate your comments and your critiques. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll be back with another project soon.